Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 2186, VBA Sort by Color. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in on YouTube. I had a video out there on how to sort with VBA, and they wanted to sort by color with a VBA, which is much more complicated. I said, well, why don't you just turn on the macro recorder and see what happens? And unfortunately, the macro recorder, you know, it gets us close, but it doesn't get us all the way there. So view, macros, record macro, how to sort by color, store macro in this workbook, perfect, click OK. All right, so now that the macro recorder is running, we're going to come here to the data tab and we're going to say sort. We're going to use the sort dialog box and we're going to build this. All right, so we're going to say that we want to add a level, sort on cherry, but not sort on cell values. We're going to sort on cell color. Cell color is the fill color there, and we want to put red on top and then copy that level and put yellow second. And then we'll add a new level. We'll go to column D, the date column, sort on cell color, red first, copy that level, yellow. And then over here in Elderberry, column E, there's a few blue font. I don't want to see what that looked like. So we'll add that as a sort on font color with blue on top. And then if all of these are a tie for no colors at all, we'll add one final level just on column A, cell values, largest to smallest, and click OK. All right, now a couple things. Don't skip this next step. Your file right now, I guarantee you, to store it as xlsx. This is a great time to do file save as, and save it as xlsm or xlsb. If you don't do that, all of your work to this point will be lost when you save this file. They will delete the macros of anything stored in xlsx. All right, so we've stopped recording there, and then we want to go look at our macros. So you can do this with view macros, view macros, and find the macro we just recorded, how to sort by color, and click edit. All right, so here's our macro, and as I look at this, the problem that we have is today we happen to have 25 rows plus a heading, so it goes down to row 26, and they've hard coded that they're only going to look at down to rows 26. But as I think about this, especially compared to the old VBA for sorting, we don't have to specify the whole range, just one cell in the column. So anywhere where they have colon C26, I'm going to reduce it down to just say, hey, no, look at the first cell in that column. So E2 and then here A2. So in my case, I had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sort levels, 6 things to change. And then this is the part that the macro recorder gets really, really bad, is they're only going to sort to rows 26 all the time. So I'm going to change this. I'm going to say, look, start at range A21 and extend it to .CurrentRegion. .CurrentRegion. Let's take a look in Excel and see what that does. So if I would just choose any one cell, A1 or anything, and press Control asterisk, it selects the current region. Or like, let's do it here from the middle, Control asterisk. And what that does is it extends in all directions until it hits the edge of the spreadsheet, the top of the spreadsheet, or the right edge of the data, or the bottom edge of the data. So by saying A1.CurrentRegion, it's like going to A1 and pressing Control asterisk. All right, so here you have to change that thing. Now everything else in the macro is fine. It's all going to work. They got the sort on cell color and sort on font color and sort on Excel. I don't have to worry about any of that. All I have to do is look in here and see that they hard-coded the region that they were going to use for the range, hard-coded how far those went, it doesn't need to be hard-coded. And with that simple step, changing those 6 items and the 7th item, we have something that should work. Now, let's do the test. Let's come back here to Excel, and we will add some new rows at the bottom. I'll just put 11s there, and we will add a couple of reds, a red, a yellow, and then over here a blue. All right, so if we go run this code, so I click in here, click the run button, and then come back, we should see that that 11 became the top item in red, it showed up there in the yellows, and it shows up in the blues. So that is all working perfectly. Why did it go to the top? Because it happened that the last sort is column A, and so remember, when there's a tie, it looks to column A as the tiebreaker. So that code is working. To learn how to write VBA, I, along with Tracy Searstead, have written a series of books, Excel, VBA, and Macros, There's been an addition now for 2003, 2007, 2010, 2013, and 2016, soon 2019, right? So go find the version that matches your version of Excel, and this will get you up the learning curve. Wrap up, today's episode is how to use VBA to sort by color. The easiest way to do this, especially since you don't know what RGB codes were used for each of the colors, you just chose red, you don't know what the RGB code is, and you don't want to go look it up. Turn on the macro recorder using View, Macros, Record New Macro. After you're done doing the sort, click Stop Recording, it's in the lower left-hand corner. Alt F8 to see a list of macros, or the View tab, Macros, and then View Macros, that's confusing. Select your macro and click Edit, and anytime that you see C2 to some range number, just change it to point to row 2, and then where they specify the range to sort, range A1.CurrentRegion will expand. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.